Tonight we thank God that he has brought us into the revelation of his word to cause a change in our lives, to cause a miracle to happen. That is why we are beginning our study from Romans chapter 12. And I know that usually we focus on the third verse or the second verse and don't pay attention to the mystery of the first verse, because the sacrifice and consecration must begin in your mind. You must rewire your thought life. Otherwise, you will keep making excuses for your sin. If you pay attention to what is happening to the culture, we are now calling wrong right. We're trying to make wrong legitimate, because the people involved in the wrong have no solution to it, so they succumb to the demonic pressure, to the oppression of these satanic vices. But beloved, change begins when your mind agrees with the word of God. And God will grant you mercy. If you don't defend your sin, God will grant you mercy. If you don't think wrongly and protect the devils messing with you, God will grant you mercy. And all of a sudden, the altar of sacrifice will be your desire. Oh, beloved, I feel the strength of that word. Listen to it. Paul says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice. You notice yesterday I said in the Old Testament, the animal was brought to the sacrifice unwillingly. The animal was sacrificed unwillingly. But this one, you notice even before I move on, that constituted a dead sacrifice. But God is calling for a living sacrifice. That's what believers are running from. We say, no, it's too much. Oh, no, no, that's unfair. Oh, no, I can't take that. Oh, no. But beloved, that's what he called us to. And may God grant you mercy so that you will turn around and do what you said you'll never do. May God grant you mercy so you can make the sacrifice you said you will never make. May God grant you mercy so that you will forgive what you said is unforgivable. May God grant you mercy so you can do what you said you will never do. Oh, beloved, that's where it begins. In your mind. In your mind. In your mind. Remember, it is a living sacrifice. It's a living sacrifice. In other words, I'm alive. I feel the brunt of it. That's why I need the mercy of God to be able to get on that altar. Oh, haven't we all come and we've gone as far as we can go and we feel like, I can't do it anymore. But God, may God grant you mercy. May God grant me mercy to keep going, to keep deciding to do the right thing, to keep deciding, because revival fire is coming and the fire will be lit on the altar, and only the sacrifices on the altar will catch fire. Only the sacrifices on the altar will be consumed by the fire of God. And the blessing of the fire of God, beloved, is it doesn't kill you, it frees you. Hallelujah. It burns your chains up. It delivers you from satanic vices. It delivers you from the clutches of sin and Satan. Oh, Father, send a fire. Send revival. May our minds change. May our bodies be cleansed. May our spirit be reignited and sanctified in the name of Jesus. Ooh, glory to God. That's where it begins. He says it is a living sacrifice. Watch this. Holy. You notice? Holy. Only living sacrifices are holy. Acceptable. Only living sacrifices are acceptable. Ah, look at it. Holy, acceptable unto God. He said, which is your reasonable service. That's an amazing thing. I feel I can't go on. And yet God says, that's really the least I can do by doing what I said I can do. Wow. Don't you see that I need a change? My mind needs to be renewed so that I can agree with the word of God. So I will not justify my wrong. So I will not accommodate my wrong. The Bible says, make no provision for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. In other words, so if you know what's tripping you up, he said, don't plan for it. Don't give it any avenue to be fulfilled. You know, cut your computer off. Let somebody hold it for you for a few days until the temptation to look at the wrong thing passes. Do something to block Satan from getting to you. Oh, but beloved, when the revival comes, I promise you, you will have no desire to look at anything wrong. You will have no desire to do anything wrong. Your desire will be to the altar. Your desire will be to glorify God. Oh, get ready for revival fire. Get ready for the consuming fire of the Holy Spirit. Oh, all consuming fire. You are my heart's desire. And I love you dearly. Oh, glory to God. May God visit you today. May God visit you this week as I'm talking about the change that must take place in your mind, the reconfiguration of your mind, to believe the word of God, to stand with the word of God, to go against yourself, to stand with the word of God, and God will visit you and turn you on, and we will all catch revival fire in Jesus' name. Amen. Oh, beloved, we love you. We'll see you tomorrow. That's a cheap one. Bye-bye.